So let's now sort out the logic and the workflows and the conditionality on this pop-up. And this is quite involved. You might be scratching your head at certain parts if you're just dealing with file uploaders for certain things I'm about to demonstrate. But everything revolves around privacy in this lesson. That is, if someone is uploading their CV, they don't want anyone else to be able to access that CV aside from the company who posted the job. Hannah, in other words. So this is between Peter and Hannah. And by default, files that are uploaded aren't private, meaning that if someone uploads a file, they share the link with someone else, that person shares the link with someone else, they can all access that file. We don't want that. We want to be proper professional developers, and we want to secure our files to make sure that only authenticated users that are logged in, that match the rules that we're about to write, only they can access these CVs. Okay. Okay, so let's just move down the page here. Nothing to do here. If we double click on the progress bar file upload, now we can add in the percentage. So one of the things that is really nice on a file uploader is that Bubble exposes a state which shows the progress of a file upload because they might be super large. So we can simply point to this file uploader, file, and it's called file uploader, attach your CVs, and now we can grab the upload percentage. Very nice, upload percentage. Now I'm clicking across to attach your CV file uploader. And I have checked the box to make this private. I've set a max size of 50. You can do whatever you like here. And by the way, whenever I hover on an input or whenever I hover anywhere that Bubble has some attached documentation, you can go ahead and click on see reference, and that will take you off to the Bubble documentation, which is we've been working really hard at. So don't be afraid of documentation. Well-written documentation is actually a pleasure to read and unlocks a lot of mysteries that you might be facing. But I'm going to leave you to read that on your own time. Now, attach this file to, and this is how we make things private, and that there has to be attached to a thing in the database. But the conundrum or the little riddle we have to solve here is I would like to attach it to this application, but it has to be done on the file uploader. Therefore, we're a little bit stuck because the application doesn't exist until we click on the save button or upload CV. Only when something's in the database does it exist, and that then we can attach this file to that thing. So we're going to then, to solve this problem, we will be building a two-step process. And we will be creating an application in the background so it exists. And that means we can then, in the next step, use that created application to make this CV private. That is a mouthful. I'm guessing most of you are kind of looking around with question marks. Let's go through this and talk about it a bit further. So attach the file to. I want to attach the file to an application I'm about to make. So what we'll do is this. Let's say do a search for application. Now we're going to do a matching process here. Add a new constraint. First is candidate equals current user. Okay. So the application has to be created by me. And the next one is the job needs to equal the current page job. So this, there can only be one thing in the database that this matches to, because we're going to disable the ability to make multiple applications to the same job. Only one application. This always spit out one value. And then we're going to say the first item. Okay. But in order for this to happen, because this making file private happens on upload, so what we have to do is before we get to this step, we have to create this application that we're looking for. Okay, so to accomplish that, we need a two-step process. So this group upload, head over to the layout tab and uncheck this element is visible on page load and collapse it when hidden. When this pop-up is shown, this group won't be visible. Okay, that's great. That's going to collapse the space. So what we're going to do is use states here to show and hide things. So please click on Popup application, click on the eye icon, and then click to add a new custom state. Call that step. This is going to be a number. Two-step process. And I'm going to set a default value of 1. Okay, default value of 1. So I don't need to set a state here. It already has a default value. So I can increment this, which we will be doing. And then we can also go back down to the number 1. But we don't need to create it. By default, it's created. Okay, and to help illustrate this a bit better, I'm going to go to my elements tree and just hide group upload, just so it's out the way. So this is what it looks like to begin with, okay? So now let's add a workflow here. Add a workflow on upload CV. And in fact, why don't we say next here? Next, two-step process. And this button, I actually want it to be the same width or not any smaller. So I'm going to make it 86 in width. So min width, 86. Let's go ahead and add a workflow. And the first thing we're going to do is create a new application. Okay, I'm going to add all fields. Candidate is the current user. Company is the current page jobs company. Company name is the current page jobs company's name. Remember, we're doing this, which enables us to search by any field contains in the candidate dashboard table. Cover note, multi-line input, write your cover note's value. Job, current page job. Job title, current page job title. And then we don't need shortlisted because that is functionality coming in section 7. And then what we'll do is set status to pending. So pending means it's been lodged, it's been made, the application, and now we're waiting for the company person representative, Hannah, to make a decision. And now what we're going to do is say set state of the pop-up, which is currently 1, but now we're moving to the next step. Okay, we've created the application and we have saved the multi-line input. We're going to the next step now. Then the value is 2. So check this out. Back in the design tab, on the multi-line input, we're going to use the layout tab here, uncheck visible and page load, collapse when hidden. On the conditional tab, we're going to say only show this when the pop-up application's step under custom states is 1, which I'm going to type on my keyboard. That's when it's visible. Now I'm going to head over to my elements tree. I'm going to open up group upload. And I'm going to change pop-up application. Let me just click back in group upload. Currently, this is hidden by default, collapse when hidden. Let's do a similar condition. Pop-up applications step is, this time is step 2. And in the workflow, we've just created that step. That's when it's visible, which means that now this multi-line input will be hidden and this next step will be visible. Fantastic. Okay. But we've also got this next button to deal with. So on step 1, it's, we say next, and on step 2, let's define a condition. Pop-up applications, step is 2, and now we're actually going to change the text. We're going to go down to text, and instead of next, we're going to change it to submit application. How cool is that? Two-step process. And it has a min width, but no max width on this button, so that's fine. Okay. And it's at this stage that someone will upload their CV, And the application has just been created in step one. So we can find an application to attach this file to. So now you can understand the two-step process. We wanted to make the file private. To make it private, we have to attach it to a thing in the database. So therefore, in step one, we created the thing, and then we made the file uploader with the progress bar visible. Okay. So let's click on edit this workflow, because we need to add a condition here. Okay. We need to add a condition that says only create this application when pop-up applications step is one. So now we can split this workflow. I'm going to copy this event and paste. Let's say step two this time. It's the same button being used at two different steps. And in step two, we're not creating an application anymore. We're making changes to an application. Okay, so make changes to thing. And actually, I've thought of another idea here. So we can create the application and set the state of the pop-up. What about another state where we can save the application as a state? Okay, so on the design tab, please head back to your pop-up, click on the eye icon, and let's create another custom state. This will be called application. Application is an application and create. No default, but we're going to set the state on this workflow with pop-up application step is one. We're going to create the application. We're going to set the state of the step to two, and we're going to set another state for application, which is the result of step one. The work we did here has outputted an application for us to use as a state. So now we can go back to step two, and I apologize for jumping around a lot here, but it's coming together, okay? It's coming together, and we will revise this at the end of the lesson. So now when we make changes to this application, and I can just reference the state. Pop-up applications, application. Boom, that's the state. And what I want to do here is add the CV. Okay, so I'm going to add a new field. This is CV, and this is a type of file. And that's going to come from the file uploader. File uploader attaches CVs. Value. And it's at that stage that now we can hide the pop-up application. And why don't we show a message? We need an alert. Okay, so I don't think we have an alert currently. So let's go find, what I'm going to do. We do have a style, but in terms of positioning, I want to go back to the company page and find an alert. All right, I'm going to search for it. Here it is here, this alert. Okay, I'm going to copy this. I'm going to go back to the job page, and I'm just going to edit, paste, and that's what we need. There it is there. So let's head back to the workflow once you've done that, guys. Actually, this needs to say application submitted. Yeah, really like that. So that would be on step two, guys. So step two, make changes to the application, hide the pop-up, and show the message. Yeah, it's only one message. Okay, that was quite a lot to take in. Let's just have one more run through, then we'll take a break, and then we're actually going to log in as Peter, we'll make sure we are logged in, and then try apply for a job. So let's run through this again. So Peter lands on the job, and he goes to apply for the job. And to do that, we're going to show the pop-up application. The pop-up application is a two-step process. This is step one, where we'll have Peter write his cover note. When he clicks on next, we're going to create the application with all the data that we have so far, except for the file. that comes in step two. So we create everything we know that we need for now, and then we're going to increment the step to two, the state to two, and then we're going to set a state of the application because we need that to make changes to that application in the next step. Okay, and then after that, the design changes, and we don't see the multi-line input, but we do see this upload here. This is exactly what it'll look like. A user clicks on attach your CV. So we search for the application and we need to match the current user, which is Peter, with the current page job. And that has already been created, it's in the database. So we're nice and private now. And then we click on the next button again, which will then say submit application. Then we edit the workflow. And that is step two. And it's at step two that we go find the application. It's now set as a state, pop-up applications application. And that's when we can link in the CV, which is the file. Then we're going to hide pop-up and let's just reset relevant inputs as well. What we might need to do here is reset data in group upload. So reset relevant inputs should take care of the multi-line input, but file uploaders often need us to reset data in the group upload. All right, guys, so that takes care of that. That is probably the most challenging part of this course. So if you understand it, congrats. If you don't worry at all. You're just starting your journey. You're going to learn through the process of repetition. There's more functionality to come as well. So let's take a quick break, and when we get back, we need to look at our privacy rules, and then we're going to actually lodge an application or create an application for a job. I'll see you in that lesson.